YouTube is an amazing place to watch your favorite people have fun and keep it real, but sometimes these stars go way too far for a few views. Throughout YouTube's history, several incidents have caused the internet to go into a frenzy. YouTubers were so pleasant when they first started, but the demanding industry can quickly lead to insane and oftentimes awkward confrontations. From beauty vlogger drama to a real criminal cases, YouTube is definitely causing all the drama lately. That being said, let us get into the top 10 awkward moments that ever happened with YouTubers. But before you do, don't forget to subscribe to YouTuber TV, like and click the bell icon. 10. Reset sentenced to jail for an Oreo toothpaste prank. YouTuber Kang Hua Ren, aka Reset, was sentenced to 15 months in prison and given a $22,300 fine after he filmed himself handing a homeless man an Oreo filled with toothpaste instead of cream. A Barcelona court found him guilty of violating the moral integrity of his prank victim back in 2017. Reset had monetized the Oreo video, which has now been removed from YouTube, and it earned him more than 2,000 euros. In the video, Reset said this about the homeless man: "This will help clean his teeth. I don't think he has cleaned them since he became poor." While this sentence may seem harsh for a non-violent offense, the judge explained how this was not a one-time thing, and that Reset enacted cruel behaviors toward vulnerable victims. The court also ruled to shut down his YouTube and other social media accounts for 5 years. 9. YouTubers accused of promoting a scam. This past year, YouTubers like Shane Dawson, Philip DeFranco, and H3H3 Productions promoted BetterHelp, an online counseling service that claims to provide professional and affordable therapy. Along with other famous YouTubers, Shane and Philip have shared that BetterHelp is like having a counselor or therapist, but in the comfort of your own home via phone or online. But what seemed like an easy-to-use, supportive app might actually be a huge scam. In early October, YouTubers Keemstar and PewDiePie both criticized BetterHelp's questionable services. Though BetterHelp advertises that it charges $65 a week for their counseling, their terms of service reveal that it will bill users on a monthly basis. Plus, according to PewDiePie, the fine print on BetterHelp's website previously disclosed that it does not guarantee the verification of the skills, degrees, qualifications, licensure, certifications, credentials, competence, or background of any counselor. This statement has since been suspiciously deleted from the website. 8. Beauty YouTuber slammed for racist comments. Tensions among the YouTube beauty community have been at an all-time high for a few years, and it seems to revolve around none other than Jeffree Star. Though Jeffree has been involved in a lot of controversy in the past, his feud with Laura Lee, Gabriel Zamora, and Manny MUA might have been his most dramatic and complicated yet. After Shane Dawson's docuseries about Jeffree was released, Gabriel shaded Jeffree, bringing up his racist comments from 10 years ago. In response, Jeffree's fans dug up past offensive tweets from Gabriel, Manny, Nikita, and Laura. As a result, Gabriel, Manny, and Laura all posted their own remorseful apology videos. A while after that, Jeffree wore cornrows for a Jeffree Star cosmetics campaign. People were clearly far from amused, though, and slammed him hard. 7. Logan Paul filming a dead body. Arguably the biggest YouTube scandal ever, at least as far as public uproar goes, was Logan's video from the end of 2017 or beginning of 2018 that showed a person who had committed suicide in Japan's suicide forest. Whilst the deceased's face was blurred out, it was still quite clear he had committed suicide. Keep in mind that most of Logan's fans are kids. Logan and his crew attempted to make gallows humor when they stumbled upon the body, but it quickly fell flat and angered the entire world. Every single person condemned Logan's actions. He apologized, but that only created more controversy after it was alleged he monetized his apology video. YouTube kind of cut ties with Logan, eventually suspending all ads on his videos. However, not long after, Logan was allowed to monetize his work again. During this phase, Logan managed to piss people off yet again by tasering a dead rat. His other vlogs during his visit to Japan also sparked backlash, revealing how he treated the Japanese people, completely disrespecting their culture and customs. 6. People willingly ate Tide Pods for a challenge. We don't think this needed to be said, but do not eat Tide Pods. Just because a bunch of teens and huge YouTube stars like GlowZell Green filmed videos of themselves eating the detergent doesn't mean you need to do so as well. It's incredibly dangerous and potentially lethal. The Tide Pod Challenge took the internet by storm in early 2018, with stores going so far as to literally lock up the detergent packets like some places do with spray paint. This is why we can't have nice things. Reportedly, poison control centers received the same number of calls during the 15 days of 2018 as they did in all of 2016. Yikes. 5. The entrance exam controversy. Olivia Jade shocked her fans when it was revealed that the lifestyle and beauty YouTuber with almost 2 million YouTube subscribers was at the center of a college entrance exam controversy, otherwise known as Operation Varsity Blues, thanks to the charges leveled against her famous parents, Full House star Lori Loughlin and fashion mogul Mossimo Giannulli. According to court documents, Loughlin was charged with conspiracy to commit mail fraud and honest services mail fraud to get her children into college. Her parents agreed to pay bribes amounting to $500,000 in exchange for having their two daughters appointed as recruits to the USC Croom team, despite the fact that they did not participate in Crew, hence securing their admission to the University of Southern California. As a result of the arrest, Olivia's endorsement deals disappeared into thin air and she was forced to disable the comments on all of her social media. 4. PewDiePie supports an anti-Semitic channel. No stranger to controversy, one of YouTube's most popular content creators, Swedish vlogger Felix Kilber, aka PewDiePie, found himself in hot water back in 2017 after he praised a Nazi YouTube channel that was reportedly known for its anti-Semitic content. He was then discovered to have Nazi imagery in 9 of his videos, with the vlogger later claiming that any anti-Semitic insinuations were nothing more than a joke. Later that year, during a live stream of a game, he called another player a racial slur, which again drew major criticism. He really does seem to be on an offensive streak, doesn't he? 3. The Fine Brothers' attempt to copyright the word react. This is a case study of how you can lose all your fans in about a day by being greedy. The Fine Brothers were among the most popular YouTube personalities, mostly thanks to their React series of videos, where kids, adults, animals, and fruit all react to certain things. A basic concept which a lot of people have since taken inspiration from. But then, in January 2016, they announced plans to license and trademark the whole React series, letting creators make their own version of it only with their permission. However, to do this, they had to apply to trademark the term React, which is used in many videos unrelated to their channel. This decision was met with backlash from their fans and other YouTubers, many of whom believe that they were trying to stop the creation of reaction videos by people unconnected to their channel. Despite insisting that they would not be copyright striking and taking revenues from other types of reaction videos, people had reported multiple copyright takedowns of their work. All of this led to a drastic decrease in their subscribers. Less than a month later, they took back all React trademark claims, apologized for pissing off their viewers, and carried on, hoping no one noticed. 2. The Vitamin Gummy Drama. The YouTube beauty world is as toxic as several of the chemicals that have been found in their products, with the biggest stars not only competing against each other to come out on top with their video content, but also now with their vast makeup empires. In the pettiest YouTube argument in years, James Charles and Tati Westbrook, two of the YouTube makeup heavyweights, butted heads over competing brands. When James promoted a vitamin gummy product that was a competitor to one of Tati's products, yeah, it really is that petty. She fired back with a now deleted 43-minute long video calling him out for this, as well as adding that he acts in a predatory and inappropriate manner toward men. James filmed an apology video before taking some time out from YouTube whilst losing millions of subscribers in the process. Long story short, they've since got over their fight about vitamins and he seems to have gained more than a few subscribers back. 1. TanaCon. If Tana Mojo will be remembered for anything, it will be the utter dumpster fire that was TanaCon. When VidCon refused to brand Tana a featured creator, she created the self-named TanaCon in retaliation, hosting it at the Anaheim Marriott Suites on the same day as VidCon. The event was sold well over capacity, leaving fans stuck outside in the sun for hours. And when they got inside, the convention was little more than a hotel hallway with nothing to do. The gift bags given to VIPs consisted of wristbands and other weird little knickknacks. Frustrated attendees compared it to the disastrous Fyre Festival, and security shut down the whole thing after just a few hours. And that concludes our list of top 10 awkward moments that ever happened with YouTubers. Let us know in the comment section below which one of these personally made you cringe the most. Thank you for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell icon.